हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लाइक यस्टरडे वी हैव स्टार्टेड स्पेक्ट्रम और स्पेक्ट्रा. व्हेन व्हाइट लाइट इज पास थ्रू एन प्रिज्म, इट स्प्लिट्स इनटू अ ब्यूटीफुल कलर्ड बैंड व्हिच इज नोन एज ए स्पेक्ट्रम. एंड दिस स्पेक्ट्रम इज ऑफ टू टाइप्स, कंटिन्यूअस एंड लाइन स्पेक्ट्रम. कंटिन्यूअस स्पेक्ट्रम मीन्स व्हेन ऑल वेवलेंथ इज अब्सॉर्ब्ड और एमिटेड. एंड लाइन स्पेक्ट्रम मीन्स व्हेन ओनली स्पेसिफिक वेवलेंथ लाइन्स आर प्रेजेंट. Like electromagnetic spectrum is of continuous spectrum in which high wavelength and low frequency lines are present. Line spectrum means which only specific wavelength lines are present, like a salt of sodium which emits a yellow color light and potassium which colors emits violet color light. Like when sodium salt is by making it's a paste and then on a flame it changes the color of a flame which emits a yellow color light. Only specific color is there is known as a line spectrum. Then these spectrum of two types, emission spectrum and absorption spectrum. Emission spectrum means emission of light, when lights is emitted, radiations are emitted, like sunlight. Sunlight is example of emission spectrum, when there is a energy or radiant energy is emitted, like when we are heating any substance or any element, that also emits light, emission spectrum. Absorption spectrum means when any sample, first radiations pass through them or it absorbs the lights or the radiations is known as a absorption spectrum. And though when the light or radiations are absorbed, then dark lines are emitted. Bands of different dark lines are emitted is known as a absorption spectrum. And study of these spectrums, emission or absorption spectrum, is known as a spectroscopy. Next is the Bohr's model of hydrogen atom. What he said, like in the center there is a nucleus and electrons are revolving around the nucleus in their fixed orbits or in their fixed path. Energy of these electrons is fixed. They do not lose their energy or not gain the energy. Only when the transition takes place among these two different orbits, then frequency of emitted and absorbed energy can be calculated by this equation. When frequency is equal to delta E upon H, delta E means that is change in energy and it is E2 minus E1, and electrons moves in a fixed path according to Bohr's model, and it is that advantage over Rutherford model which tells that electrons around moving the electrons around the nucleus and they continuously emitting their energy and ultimately collapse with the nucleus. But Bohr explained that their path is fixed and energy is also fixed. But there are some limitations of Bohr's model. First one is it do not applicable when that atom of any electron, when the number of electron of any atom is more than one, and it do not explain the detailed spectra of hydrogen. These are the limitations of Bohr's model. Next are the, we use their term orbital. Electrons moves in their fixed orbits. What are these orbitals? It is the space around the nucleus. Like this is the nucleus in which protons and neutrons are present, and it is the space around the nucleus where the probability of finding the electron is maximum. Maximum number of electrons can be found around the nucleus. It's known as a orbital. Next are the quantum numbers. Generally, four quantum numbers are present which specify the energy, size, shape, and orientation of an orbital. What are these? First one is n. Any number 1, 2, 3, 4, and then there are the shell numbers. Shell numbers means around the nucleus, like this is the first shell, second shell, K, L, M, N. These are the number of shells. Now total number of orbitals in shell, that formula is n square. First, if it is 1, then it, if it is 2, 2 square 2 is 4, then 3 is 9. If n is 4, then it is 16. Now number of electrons, it is calculated by formula 2n square. 2n square means if it is 1, then it comes 2. If it is 2, then it is 8. 2 into 2, 4. 4 into 2, 8. Then it is 3. 3 into 3, 9. 9 into 2, 18. If it is 4, then it is 32. So in this way, that number of electrons are calculated. That is, formula is 2n square. Rest we will do tomorrow.